Bishut Rabbi Rabotai, today, Baruch Hashem, the parasha of this week is Eliyahu Yitzhak. This is the descendants of Yitzhak. And Baruch Hashem, we can say this is the descendants of Moshe, my son. Today, he just had a baby son. And as you know, when a neshama comes to this world, there is a simcha as well to come to this world, especially when the neshama, she's going to take a name of a tzaddik, because Baruch Hashem, we have some names of big tzaddikim. So of course, the zikrut of the Brit Milah, it has a big impact in the world. Not only my grandson, any Jew. And this is the as you know, when there is a baby boy born, everybody is happy, everybody is talking about it. But if it was a girl, no one talk. No one to cry. Why is this? But the contrary, when the United Kingdom, when they had a baby girl, everybody is talking about the girl. But by the Jew, when it's a girl, nobody talk about it. But it's a boy, everybody talk about it. But by non-Jewish people, no matter what, if it's a boy or girl, everybody will talk a lot. What is this? Is it a discrimination between boy and girl? No. The difference between boy and girl in Jewish law, it's only because there is a Brit Milah. There is a mitzvah. When you have a Brit Milah, there is a mitzvah. So a mitzvah, because there is a mitzvah, so everybody is happy to do this mitzvah. A girl, of course, she's welcome. But because there is no mitzvah right away, so that's why there is no rash. People don't talk too much about it. So, this morning I wanted to talk to you about something very, very special. Yesterday, we have been talking about the reason why Abraham Avinu he had to send Eliezer for the Shidduch. You know, lately, a lot of people, they don't know that the Shidduch, the first one who did the Shidduch, it was Hashem. It was Hashem who introduced Hava to Adam HaRishon. That was the first Shidduch. And that was a perfect Shidduch. When something comes from Hashem, it's a perfect Shidduch. But today we have no, today is Hashem cannot be all the time the Shatran. So today, Baruch Hashem, today there is people who do the Shidduch. So that's why you have to pray a lot to Hashem, that the Shidduch, that the one who will do it, it will be a perfect Shidduch, a Shidduch that it will last, a Shidduch that it will have a late success. We saw the Shidduch that Hashem made to Adam HaRishon, it was a perfect, you know why? Because we should not think that the Shidduch that Hashem made to Adam HaRishon, it was an invention. Don't forget that Hava was taken from Adam. When Hashem created Adam and Hava, they were both together. So just Hashem separated them. So this is the real Shidduch. That means that's why how much you have to pray to Hashem that you will get what it is yours. You have to pray to Hashem that to get what it is yours, not to get something that it's not yours. And for that, you have to pray to Hashem. For that, you need tefillot. You need a lot of tefillot. Otherwise, it's going to be a problem. But now you see why there is today a lot of divorce. Why there is a lot of divorce? Because the only real marriage that can last, only if it is, if the Shidduch came from HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And that the Shidduch, if you want that the Shidduch will come from HaKadosh Baruch Hu, you have to respect exactly the laws that Hashem give you. If you respect the laws that Hashem give you, so it's going to be the real Shidduch from HaKadosh Baruch Hu. So the second Shidduch that was a perfect one, It was the one of Eliezer. That was fantastic. Why? So yesterday, there was a rabbi yesterday who asked me a question. He said, why Abraham Avinu did not go himself to do the Shidduch? I mean, can you imagine? Here we're talking about Jews, about generation. I mean, Abraham was an old man. Okay, but he should go. Even as he was old, Abraham was a very strong man. Don't forget, as his age, when his wife, she died, he had another 10 children. He got married again and he had 10 children. So he was a strong man. Don't forget, don't worry. So why Abraham Avinu? He should go to look a girl from his family. Why to send Eliezer? He had to make him swear. It seemed like he did not trust him. Abraham Avinu trust all the time Eliezer, but for the Shidduch he did not trust him. So he had to make him swear with the Brit Mila. So Abraham, go yourself. Besides this, you know, Abraham, he knows Shema Meforash. The same way that Eliezer, he went 24 hours, he made round trip, 24 hours trip, with Shema Meforash. He said the name of Hashem, he arrived. Don't forget, he left Eretz Canaan in the morning, he arrived in the afternoon, the next day he came back with Rivka. So it's easy. If for Abraham it took him, if for Eliezer it took him 24 hours, for Abraham it would take him only a few hours. So why Abraham will not go? He will go for the Shidduch. So it's a good question. Yes, it's a good question. And I was thinking two things. First, here we learn how much Abraham Avinu Alav Shalom, it was very important for him. He was Zakin Yushev Ba'yeshiva. He was an old man, but always he was in the yeshiva. The Gemara said, the Midrash said, the Abraham Zakin Baba Yamin, Abraham never wasted a minute. He was an old man, but never wasted a minute. Today we wasted millions of minutes. Abraham, every minute of his life was calculated. It was full of Avodat Hashem. All Abraham Avinu was full of Avodat Hashem. Abraham Avinu. So Abraham Avinu, what it was is Avodat Hashem. Besides saving Hashem, he did Zikri Arabim. He put people to the Teshuvah. He teach people to believe in Hashem. That was Abraham Avinu. He teach people. So for Abraham Avinu, Hashem, he said, well, it's better for me to stay, carry on my work. Every minute that I'll be there, I will lose a soul here. At least here I will take care of them. Even if I do, a lot of people do it teshuvah there and haram. But I have to leave them. If I leave them, it's no good. So it's better for me to remain. And then I can send Eliezer. That was Abraham Avinu Alav Shalom. The Zikri Rabim. The Anashim B'Tshuva. So he said, don't forget one thing. Always we thought that we cannot do a Shidduch. Always we thought that if somebody wants to get married, so he should go himself. No, for me you can know that all the Shidduch that we do, we can do this with somebody. Or say, Adan Sheliach Kemoto. I mean, I can't trust you to find a girl for me. I can't trust you to find a girl for my daughter. I can't trust you. And we learned that from Eliezer, from Abraham and Eliezer, that I have something incredible. Incredible for you. They met, I discovered what I want to tell you, I was shocked. Abraham Avinu Alav Shalom, he wanted one girl from his family. He wanted a girl from his family. Now, there is the Hiddush Haran, a big tzaddik, he asked a question. He said, what it is the difference between girls of Eretz Kanaan and girls of Haran? They're the same. They're bad girls. They're bad girls. The girls of Kanaan, they're bad. And the girls of Haran as well are bad. So what's the difference? Why Abraham didn't want to take a girl from Kanaan? You know what he said? The Haran? Baruch Hashem, I thought the same way. It's Kavanti that. Baruch Hashem, I thought the same way. I give the answer as well. The difference between the girls of Haran and the girls of Eretz Kanaan is that the girls of Eretz Kanaan, they had bad midot. When a girl has bad midot, you cannot change it. When a girl gets born with bad, like yesterday a woman came to see me and she told me, why my daughter, she's not like me? Yesterday. And her daughter, she's a religious one. And the mother, she's not her. So I told her, what do you want her to be like? Why? She said, she's more religious than me. Why? I'm not enough Jewish? I said, yes, she has good Jew, but in Jewish life, you can always improve. Like in money, you are rich, you want to be twice rich. You have 1 million, you want 2 million. You want three. You have three, you want six. You have 1 billion, you want 2 billion. And the Jewish life, religion, as well. You have to improve. She wants to improve. Why to stop her? And she looked at her and she told her, I will not talk to you. I don't want to talk to you till you change your way of life. In front of me, she can speak this like to sort of the madame. When I have a problem, I remember her when she had the breast cancer. I said, when you had the breast cancer, I saw you 5-6 years ago. You were crying, you were afraid. Now this is the way to say thank you to Hashem. She said, why the doctors, say, well, okay, next time that you are not well, don't come to see me. No, but you don't curse me. I don't curse you. I just tell you that even the doctors, it's Hashem who give the direction to the doctors to make you well. It's not the doctor. Who's the doctor? It is nothing. Of course, it's a mitzvah to go to the doctor, but the real doctor is Rifaeno, it's Hashem. You see, midot, qualities. Bad qualities. When somebody is born with bad qualities, you cannot change him. It's a miracle to change him. But if you have good qualities, even if you do Avodah Zarah, why you do Avodah Zarah? Because you think God, it's a tree. The tree is the God. But the day that you know that the tree is only a tree, it's not God, so you change. So the Hiddush Harim, the Haran, he said, this is the difference between the girls of Eretz Kanaan and the girls of Haran. The girls of Eretz Kanaan, they had bad qualities. Bad qualities. And to be a Jew, you must have Derech Eretz in Torah. Derech Eretz Kadma LaTorah. With no Derech Eretz, there is no Torah. With no good qualities. Look, even Hashem, he did not give the Torah to Am Yisrael until he did they repaired all their Memtech Aritoma, all the bad qualities. If you have good, bad qualities, even if you have Big Tanit Hacham, you are zero. You can have a long beard, a long peel. You can know the whole Torah. If you have bad qualities, Dashamara, you are jealous, your Torah is zero. Your Torah is zero. The first thing what we should see in a girl when we want to get married, her qualities. How are they? And of course, you see the family. But according to the qualities of the family, the girl will be. Or the boy will be. So now then, that's why Avraham Avinu didn't want a girl for its half from Eretz Kanaan. Okay. But he wanted a girl from his family, Haran. Haran as well, they are not good people. But they had a good heart. The family of Avraham Avinu had a good heart. They have chesed. They had the good qualities. They had good qualities. They were of the Avodah Zarah. did Avodah, they were idolatry, but it's nothing idolatry. Idolatry is nothing, because you think this is God. You see the sea, the sun, you think the sun is God. But the day that you realize that the sun is only the sun, it's not God, so you change your mind. But you have good, bad qualities, it's hard. It's hard to change it. Only through Musar you can change your bad qualities. Only Musar. You take a Peleoid, you take a Chutzadikim, you take a Mehamloid, you take a good book of Musar, Misilat Yesharim. Only through this you can. I will not go to bed, I will not go to sleep if I don't read something, or if I don't think about a rabbi history. Like I would tell you something. You know, there was Rabbi Elhanan Bar Sarman Alav Shalom. The day that he had a baby boy, he came to the Chafetz Chaim. He told him, Rabbi, wish me Mazel Tov. So Chafetz Chaim said, Mazel Tov for what? I had a baby boy today, so I have to travel to my town for the Brit Milah. So the Chafetz Chaim said, what about the Torah? If you travel to your city, it will take you 2 days, and then 2 days to come back, you're going to spend time at the Brit Milah. You had a son. So he said, yes, you can make a shaliach. You can tell somebody to go and to be your shaliach and to do the Brit Milah instead of you. You stay in the Torah. Who can do that? That's what he did. He did not go for the Brit Milah of his son, and he sent a shaliach to represent him. Who can do that? If I do that, she will divorce me. Up to now, my wife, every time she reminded me that I was not present in the city when she had the baby boy, Mikhail, my son. I was in Paris. I did not know that she had got another baby. So that she had to go. But till now, she reminded me. Yes, I went to hospital on my own. You were not there. What can I tell her? Can I tell her what Rabbi Hamad Vassaman did? This is tzaddikim. This is, you see, when you have good midot, you're the best. So that's why Abraham Avinu, he wanted a girl from his family. Because the girl from his family, okay, they were idolatries. They did Avodah Zarah. But they had good quality, they had good midot. So now you understand. For Abraham Avinu, he has a personal interest. He wants a girl from his family. And because he wants a girl from his family, he will not shake very much. That way he sent Eliezer. Because Eliezer, he has no negiah. The only negiah, the only personal interest that he had, it was his daughter. That he wanted Abraham to take his daughter for Yitzhak. But since he knew that Abraham don't want his daughter, so that he has no interest. It's like, if you have an interest on me, you need me. So you will do anything to please me. Do you know why? Because if you don't do it, I will not do what you want. Abraham Avinu, he has a personal interest. What was his inigah ishit? Because he wanted, no matter, a girl from his family. So he will not check about the girl. He will not check at 100%. Because he wants a girl from his family. That's why Abraham Avinu decided not to go. And besides this, because Abraham Avinu wanted only a girl from his family, he will not pray as he should pray for a good mother. But that's why he sent Eliezer. We saw Eliezer, how much he prayed to Hashem. How much sign is he asked from Hashem to give him a real mazal for Yitzhak. Bemet. For a real mazal, you are really to pray. You know, Rabbi Chaim Mitzanz, Alav Shalom, he was a big tzaddik. He had to do Simon and Bur to get married. But Rabbi Chaim Mitzanz, when he was working, he used to, I would say that, get Soleah.
Koho
is in Spanish, but in English.
He was crippled.
He did not walk right. Right. Used to walk, you know, like he needed, it's like his foot, they were not equal. Mm-hmm. So he could walk, walk very, very bad. So every shidduch that they introduced him, the girl always in the family said no. And okay, when they propose you a shidduch, you have to accept. And after, if it's not right, so, but always you have to accept. Never say no to somebody. You never know. So now, when they really introduce him the one that's supposed to be his wife, she said no, because she saw him walking the way he was walking. So he said to his father, to her father, can you let me just 1 minute to talk to her? So the father said, so the father of the girl said, but she don't want the shidduch. He said, please give me only 1 minute. And after 1 minute, finished. But if you don't mind, bring me a big glass. A big glass. And put it in front of the wall. Why you want it? You will see. Rabbi Hamitzas was a tzaddik. He was not an old man. To do what he did now. To do what he did. Well, I mean, he must be a big tzaddik. Maybe he was 16, 15, 17 years old. So he took the glass, he put it in front of the wall, and he told the girl, you don't access me as a shidduch because of my infirm, because I am an infirm, I cannot walk right. She said, no. I said, okay. He told her, can you watch the glass? No, walk in front of the glass. When she was walking in front of the glass, she was walking, she saw that she was walking very, very, very bad. And Rabbi Hamitzat, he started to walk, he walked perfectly. She was a scared, she was shocked, and the father was shocked. What's going on? He said, look, your daughter, she's supposed to be born infirm. And because she's going to have children, and because she was my mother, so I took her illness. Now that she don't want me, I give her back her illness. I don't want to take it. That was a behemoth. She was supposed to be my mother. So I took her illness for me, because I am a man. I can walk like this, nothing. But if you know she don't want me, why have to take her illness? She can have it back. And they got married and they had children. This is a mother. My friend, now you understand why Abraham Avinu, he could not pray because of his personal interest that he wanted a girl from his family. He will not pray at 100% for the real mother to Yitzhak. That's why he sent somebody that he had no interest. Somebody. And we saw the way Eliezer prayed to Hashem. And Hashem accepted all his tefillot. And Hashem the sin. He said to Hashem, Hashem, Hayom, that was, that day, it's already finished. This Hashem, I want now, Hayom, now. Only if, I want to see the Mazal now. And Hashem is sending the Mazal. Now you understand the question that we asked yesterday. Why Abraham had to make Yitzhak Eliezer to swear? Why would not host him? You know, my friend, Yerat Shamayim is not easy. To fear Hashem is not easy. It's very hard to fear Hashem. It's not easy. I'm telling you. To fear Hashem is something that... And you know, the Avadim, the slaves, sometimes they are free. Sometimes they have no Yerat Shamayim. So that's why Abraham Avinu had to make him swear. Because if Eliezer will swear, every time that he wants to make a bad decision, he will remember that he swear to Abraham Avinu. Look what we have here. We have here a talit. Why should he give us this talit? The talit is like to remind you. It's a motto of Scharten. שכתיבה זיסמן, בחפץ חיים, יקול, תתלית, it's a medai. Medai. When a king wants to give you a medai because you served him well, so he gives you a medai, you know, you carry with you this beautiful medai of the king. Hashem, he loves us so much, he gives us a special medai, the talit, to remind you what is your duty in this world, what you have to do, what you should do. When you see the Gemara said, when you look at your talit, and the talit there is a blue, the chelet. You think about the sky, look over the sky. The sky is blue. When you say the sky, automatically you think about Hashem. There was a man who told me something. He said, when he feels, it's good what he told me. He said, when he feels he has his tzara, and he wants to do something bad, what he does, he looks at the sky and he smiles. So I don't know why you do that. He said, because when you want to take a picture, you have to smile. So it's like, I think, hey, from up there, they're taking you a picture. So don't do that. Not bad. Not bad. Look, if you want to do a picture, can you imagine if you do a sad, no good. So make a smile, you smile. To have a good picture, like a wedding. If you don't smile, he said, so I love it. He said, when I have a tzara to do a avera, I look at the sky and I smile. It's like, to remind me, they're taking me a picture. So now that I know they're taking me a picture, how can I do the avera? And that was the midrash, that's what the Gavot said. Ayin ro'a, ve'ozeh shoma'at, ve'chom ha'azir chavesa. There is an eye who look at you. What does it mean there is eye who look at you? They're taking pictures. Boom, 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 boom. Yeah, Ayin ro'a. They're looking at you. There is ozeh shoma'at. There is some videos that they record all what you say. And all what you do, it's written. Yirat Shamayim. So to have Yirat Shamayim, you need a lot of patents. One of the patents of Hashem, to have Yirat Shamayim to remind yourself what Hashem wants from you. Tell it. Since it reminds you. So now that's why Abraham Avinu alav shalom, he said to Eliezer, make swear. And when you swear, it's a reminder. I was writing here this morning when Hashem, he said to Abraham, go to Pilishtim, and he went with his wife. And then he said to everybody, this is my sister. So then Abimelech, he took his wife. So the next day, Hashem came to Abimelech, the dream, and he told him, if you don't give back Sarah to Abraham, I'll kill you. So the next day, Abimelech, he said to Abraham, why didn't you tell me? He said, well, I was afraid because there is no Yirat Shamayim. I thought maybe there is no Yirat Shamayim. Because if there is no Yirat Shamayim, even if I tell you, if I choose my wife, she will kill me to take her. Yirat Shamayim. Sometimes you think you have Yirat Shamayim, you don't have it. Sometimes you can think we have Yirat Shamayim, and we don't have it. Why do you think Abimelech will steal a woman? At the time, the people were afraid to steal a woman from somebody. So why Abraham Abin was afraid? Understand it. In Egypt is still women. But in Eretz Canaan, they would not do it. So, but Abraham Abin gave us a good teaching. When there is no Yirat Shamayim, you don't think about Hashem. He said, in that moment of the Avera, in your mind, Hashem doesn't exist. Have you seen in your life somebody who did a mitzvah that he will regret why he did it? Once he did it, he's happy that he did it. But when there is an Avera to do, before he do the Avera, he don't think about Hashem. Only once he did the Avera, why I did it. The regret came after the Avera. So, because there is no Yad Shamayim. That way, Yad Shamayim is so important. And Yad Shamayim is not easy to get it. It's a work. It's a work. It's a work. You know, Abadim, they're not obligated. There is no obligation to do mitzvot. You know why? Because the Eved, you, David, you have an option. Or to be Eved Hashem, or Eved of your money, or Eved of somebody. This is the two options. So what is the option? It's to be Eved Hashem. But if you are Eved, it's like a Eved Knaap. If you are really a slave, if you are a slave, so you're not, there is no obligation. You are like a woman. You see what a woman. She's not obligated to study the Torah of the mitzvot. Eved as well cannot do. Why? Because he has a boss. So because Abraham Eliezer has a boss, who is his boss? Abraham. That's why Abraham Abinu Alav Shalom, he had to make him swear. I know that you are my Eved, and because you are my Eved, you are patur, you are not obligated to do mitzvot, but from now till you come back, I want you to be the Eved Hashem. From now till you come back, I want you to forget about me, be Eved Hashem. But as you see the history, it was a big tzaddik. Even that Abraham Abinu told him, from now on we are the Eved Hashem, because I make you swear. Every time that Eliezer talked Abraham, he mentioned Adoni, my master. I am only his Eved. He was Batel. That was he has a big success in his shlichus. Yeah. To make a good shlichut, you need a lot of seyfel shmaya. Shekadosh Baruch Hu, I just to tell you 1 hour ago, I am a grandfather. My son Moshe had a baby boy. No, Shekadosh Baruch Hu, Amen.